right here is basically the height, 3 inches. Hermosillo is 3 inches.
Theater here in Los Angeles. It is now time for our PBC on FS1 main event of the evening. 10 rounds in the featherweight division. Promoted by TGB Promotions. Sponsored by Geico, Brooklyn Boxing, and MGM Resorts. Your three judges scoring our main event at ringside will be Rudy Barragan, Dr. Lou Moret, and Zachary Young. And the referee in charge when the bell sounds is Jack Reese. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He comes in wearing the green trunks trimmed with the gold. Weighing in officially at 126.5 pounds. His record, 11 wins, 2 losses, 1 draw, 8 wins coming by way of knockout. Desde Jalisco, Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, presentando Rigoberto Hermosillo. And across the ring, his opponent fighting out of the blue corner. He comes in wearing the white trunks trimmed with the red and gold. Weighing in officially at 127 pounds. His professional record, a perfect one. 20 bouts, 20 victories, 14 of those coming by way of a knockout. Joining us from Tagbilaran, Bohol, Philippines. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the top featherweight contender, Mark Magnifico Magsayo.
Come over here, please. Facing me right here. Facing me. Good. Mark right here facing me. Mouthpiece. All right. These are good right now, Manny. They might come up a little bit, so I'm going to let them work right here. I got a righty against the lefty, so don't step on each other's feet if you can. And watch your heads. Please listen and obey my commands at all time. Protect yourself at all time. Fight hard, fight clean. Good luck to both of you.
For Rigoberto Hermosillo, there is Mark Magsayo. He said he's working on not being reckless and being smarter. For Rigoberto Hermosillo, he said everything is on the line in this fight. Everything. Hermosillo, a 3-week replacement for Jose Haro, who stepped away from the sport. In steps in the southpaw, Rigoberto Hermosillo. Mark Magsayo, no stranger to having changes. When he last fought here in the United States against Ramiro Robles, he said the exact same thing happened to him.
Ooh, good right hand right off the bat by Magsayo.
Nice left hook there by Magsayo. Mark Magsayo with a knockout percentage of 73%, but he is giving up 3 inches to Hermosillo. Ray Flores, Joe Goosen, Jordan Plant.
He is, but he's got such quick feet. You see how he gets in and out very fast, Magsayo. So he'll make up for that reach by doing that. But, you know, here's one thing he's got to be careful for is leaving that left hand low against the southpaw.
Nice straight right hand.
Boy, he's got quick hands, doesn't he?
By Magsayo.
He's got quick hands, doesn't he? But look at this.
Absolutely. But back comes Hermosillo. Hermosillo, since he was 13, has been calling Victorville, California, his home. There's a straight left by Hermosillo.
And, you know, Hermosillo, you know, obviously, you know, he's a rugged guy. And even when he was fighting Manny Robles, who had him down in the first round, he came back and rallied in that fight to make it a close fight, undefeated Manny Robles. So, you know, Hermosillo's a very durable guy. He's going to go to that liver with that left hand, okay? He's a southpaw. His strong hand is his left hand. And he's going to try to hit that body a lot with that left hand right under that rib cage, under the right elbow of Magsayo there. That's his favorite punch.
There's a whipping right cross by Magsayo.
He whipped that right into the body of Hermosillo. So, and there's that right hook by Hermosillo. And it's going to something I'm going to talk about in the keys to victory.
There's a straight right that backed up Hermosillo. Two big right hands clobbering Hermosillo.
Man, is this kid quick, Magsayo, isn't he?
He is very fluid and fast, but back comes the Mexican in Hermosillo.
I can already see the improvement with his tutelage under Freddie Roach right now, because in a few fights that I had seen on tape, he was a little bit wide. He was wasting punches. None of that here. He looked sharper, crisper. See that little left hook he tried to drop in over that right hand of Hermosillo? I like what I see right now.
Well, you mentioned about how wild Magsayo has been in the past 4 years ago. Big right hand that backed up Hermosillo. He clocked him. He had him rocked.
Boy, if he hits him again with something sharp like that,
could be lights out.
Well, at least he might put him down, but I got to tell you, that really wobbled Hermosillo. But that's the quick hands of Magsayo, man. He's just really, it's lightning fast.
25 years old from the Philippines, but back comes Hermosillo. Hermosillo has a little bit of blood outside of his right eyebrow. That ends the first.
Wow.
Let's take a look. The power punching from Magsayo. What force behind that right hand, Joe?
Well, see, look, Magsayo went to the Hermosillo went to the body with that left hand to the liver, and of course Magsayo countered right hand up next to his chin when he's going to the body with the liver shots from his left hand side, and then when he's close, he's got to hit the body hard, but he's got to protect himself.
Well, for Mark Magsayo, he's hoping to follow in the footsteps of his idol, Manny Pacquiao, and become a world champion. Pacquiao took a liking to Magsayo and feels that he can be a rags-to-riches story, much like what he's been able to do. And the Philippines certainly being well-represented. John Riel Casimero victorious last week, and here this week we see the unbeaten featherweight contender in Magsayo.
Magsayo just whistled another counter right hand right past the left hand that Hermosillo threw in there. Luckily, he pulled his head out just in time. But, man, he's really looking to counter, and he's quick with his counters, Magsayo. See, there's the body work I was talking about. When you get in close, you got to do some damage because he got hurt by Chris Avilos, Magsayo did, to the body and got dropped by him.
Yeah, he was dropped in the third round.
That's right. So, you know, he can't be hurt himself. And, look, you saw Magsayo. He just kind of pointed down to his trunks like that left hand was low, which it wasn't. It was a good straight body shot by Hermosillo right in the belly.
Blistering hand speed. That right continues to hammer away upon Hermosillo. But back comes the 28-year-old from Jalisco, and he ate a left hook.
That's right. He's good.
Forward.
That's right. That left hook is what I said. He's really dangerous with that left hand.
Here you go. Did you get any cut?
Uh-oh. Well.
No. I got a headbutt. No blood. Time in.
Midway point of the second, a clash of heads, inadvertent.
Well, Jack Reese, the referees. Oh, good left hand by
Hermosillo. And Jack Reese did a very good job to go in there, make sure they were both taken care of.
That's right.
As you pointed out, Joe, against Magsayo, for Magsayo, he's been on the deck just once against Chris Avalos, but he would go back to finish him off in the sixth round. That was in the Philippines in front of nearly 30,000.
That's right. It was a tremendous comeback. Because look, it looked like he got tired after the second round, Magsayo, because he threw so many wasted punches. And then, you know, Chris Avalos, being the great fighter he was, really went to the body hard and drained him even more, and then was able to drop him. But Magsayo, being the competitor and great fighter, as he came back to stop Chris Avalos in that fight, which shows his heart and determination.
Well, and Magsayo's coming off of a 13-month layoff. He defeated Panya Uthok, who was a former world champion, on two of the three scorecards in that fight on August 31st of last year. It was a shutout, so Magsayo's certainly getting better and trying to crack and get closer to a world title shot.
Yeah, and the record for Uthok was like 53-6. I mean, he had a heck of a record.
Magsayo certainly not afraid to test his skills against high-level opposition. Final moments of the second, but punches towards Magsayo. Here's that straight left. Boom. Magsayo took it well. On to the third. And Rigoberto Hermosillo going at it. Joe, this has been a very entertaining matchup thus far.
It's a dangerous fight for both guys because both guys are really good. And let me tell you something. Magsayo is reacting to that straight left hand that Hermosillo's throwing right into his belly. Every time Hermosillo throws that straight left hand down there, and Jack may say some race about that, but it hit the belt line, so it was legal. He's reacting to it, but I don't know if that's just a nervous thing he does. He drops his hands, Magsayo, and hits his belly right there, but it sure coincides with every time he gets hit to the body.
And let's take a look at the two losses for Hermosillo last year. He lost to Manny Robles via split decision and then came up short against Victor Slavinsky on the undercard of Wilder Ortiz number two. In the fight against Robles, he felt that he started too early and didn't have enough left down the stretch. In the fight with Slavinsky, he felt that he started, you know, too late, in his opinion.
Well, that might be true. I thought he came on later in the fight against Ramos, though. I mean, I thought that's what got him the split decision against Ramos. But look, right now, he's that experience is going to probably serve him well in this fight against a really, really tough guy in Magsayo. And there he is going to that body. But I got to tell you, he drops that right hand really low. And Hermosillo, when he jumps in with that left uppercut to the belly, and if Magsayo times that, he could catch him with a left hook as he jumped. Ooh, good straight right hand by Magsayo.
Just over the midway point of the third round.
You saw that left hook. I hate to interrupt. You saw that. See, exactly what I was saying. Magsayo tried to time that hook just like that right there.
Good combination punching by Mark Magsayo. Well, Joe, I think it is so apropos that Magsayo jettisoned his old trainers, and then he came to learn under the guidance of Freddie Roach, which Freddie and Manny Pacquiao have been like a father-son tandem for well over a decade.
Well, you know, you got to do that. Listen, sometimes your coaches run out of ideas for you because they haven't been to the, you know, to the mountain yet. They haven't been at the top of the game, and they run out of ideas for you, and you can't advance if you don't have new ideas being fed to you. So it makes sense, and Freddie's been there and back 100 times.
Well,
so,
I said a decade that they've been together, more like 2 decades if I stand corrected myself. So yes, Freddie Roach certainly knows what it's like to cultivate a young Filipino prospect and develop them into a world champion. There you see the 7-time Trainer of the Year Hall of Famer, Freddie Roach.
Yeah, and while we were discussing that, Hermosillo just pinned Magsayo on the ropes there. And like I said, he's got to go to the body hard. Boy, was he doing it right there. He landed like 4 or 5 hard shots in the row. We had Magsayo pinned on the ropes.
Final moments of the third.
Ooh.
Big right hand for Magsayo.
That is the biggest difference. And he just his defense looks tighter. Just everything about him looks better. And he's also using his energy wisely, where he didn't in the fights that we saw earlier without Freddie.
Well, he was more reckless in his previous fights, and now he is a lot more disciplined and defensive-minded, but he still has his aggression.
Yeah, well, you know, look, he's capable of boxing and pressing.
A couple of big right hands that clocked Hermosillo. Back comes Hermosillo trying to close the distance. Hermosillo looking to snap his two-fight losing streak.
Stop, both of
this is his third straight undefeated opponent.
Well, Hermosillo is really doing some good things in there, but he better keep a real tight defense against Magsayo because he's very accurate like that. You know, he just hardly ever misses that right hand. But Hermosillo's got his hands real close and tight to his face. Now, if he puts that pressure on, he's got to do things like that.
There's a big right hook, and he literally jarred back the jaw of Magsayo.
He's been landing solid punches throughout this whole fight. Don't kid yourself. It's just that Maxayo's the more flamboyant-looking guy in there, and he's got cat-like reflexes. And Hermosillo is just kind of a workman-like, landed a good body shot. He worked a couple of shots to the head, Hermosillo, then dropped that left uppercut right into the liver.
We just saw a big left uppercut at close range that found its destination for Hermosillo. But they're answering back with a right to the body was Magsayo.
That's right. Magsayo slipped inside the jab of Hermosillo and threw a right uppercut right to the belly.
Joe, this is starting to really sizzle between these two. The rivalry between the Philippines and Mexico on display here this evening.
Well, without a doubt. I don't think we've seen the best of it yet. I think this is going to get very interesting. But Hermosillo's doing what he should be doing. When he gets in close, he's really ripping the body. Even though he just missed 2 shots to the head, he should forget about the head. Just keep targeting that body to slow him down for the later round so the head opens up for you.
We are nearing 30 seconds to go in this fourth round. A left to the body by Hermosillo. Well, he is workmanlike and tries to pressure you to every inch of the ring, Joe.
Yeah, and he loves to use the left hand. I mean, he rarely uses the hook. Hermosillo, but, you know, right there, you know, he worked like three, four left hands right in a row. That's his power punch. That's where he feels comfortable. Ooh, see, there's that left hook from
Magsayo. But back comes Hermosillo towards the end of the fourth. Mark Magsayo, though, abilities here on FS1. 39 years ago, Alexis Arguello would defeat Ray Boom Boom Mancini by 14th round TKO. But back here in Los Angeles, the fifth round, Mark Magsayo and Rigoberto Hermosillo.
Stop. Break.
And Joe, would you believe that Hermosillo is averaging over 84 punches thrown per round, Magsayo just 26?
Well, look, you know, you heard Magsayo said he didn't like fighting southpaws in the fighter meeting. And this is the reason why. It's hard to get a rhythm. When you do your best work against right-handers, you feel comfortable. Some guys don't mind fighting southpaws. This is a tall southpaw, Hermosillo, with long arms. He's strong. He's determined. He puts on pressure. And, you know, Magsayo doesn't think that he, you know, gels real well with southpaws. And so it's hard to get combinations off on southpaws. I've been through it with my fighters before. And that may be the explanation.
Well, I think it just goes to show, what are you going to favor? Is it quantity or is it quality?
Well, you know, at this point, it should be quality. You know, you can't worry about the punch numbers. You just got to worry about the accuracy and the effectiveness of what you're doing with your punches. And right now, Magsayo, when he is throwing, he's being accurate and he's being effective. And we've seen him stun Hermosillo once or twice here. But Hermosillo is a hard guy to dissuade. He's going to keep on coming.
He's definitely very tough and durable. He's going to make you work, and he realizes that this fight means everything. He had such a sense of urgency, did Hermosillo, in talking with us during the fighter meetings.
Yeah, well, you know, he also thought that, you know, he should have won those two fights that he lost. I mean, you know, why wouldn't he? But he's determined to win this fight. You can just tell by the way he's fighting.
But those who are on Mark Magsayo felt, as we are under a minute to go, they believe that tonight will be the coming out party for the undefeated featherweight contender from the Philippines.
It's a beautiful left hook, right hand to the body by Magsayo. Came in so quickly. He's really good. But see, now he should be working a little bit short in here with Hermosillo and doing a little damage on the inside. Instead of just long punches or mid-range punches, when he gets inside, he should use some chopping little right hands and short little uppercuts. You know, they can do damage. They don't seem like they do a lot, but they do when you're getting hit by them.
Stop.
See, right there, he's holding on to Hermosillo's arm there, where he could have been working.
There's a big right hand, another one that connected upon Hermosillo for Magsayo. Final moments. We are halfway through this featherweight main event.
Yeah, well, here we go. Here's a little missed right hand, but he stepped in with the jab. That was an awkward effective. All right, here we go. Here's that, you know, step back and then step back and then he made a nice little turn. Just kind of what I was talking about. When you get close to a guy, let your hands go. Don't hold on and waste that time.
Joe, can you talk to us about the importance of sometimes you have to show tough love to your fighter as they come to the corner, as Freddie just did?
Without a doubt, that was nothing. There wasn't anything tough about that. I mean, to tell you the truth, that fighter's been hit with harder things tonight.
But I felt more disciplined that Freddie was kind of telling him, like, there was a sense of urgency that's coming out of
him. Well, yeah, like I said, it was an exclamation point. You know, I mean it. Let's do it. Let's start working. See, like, right in there. See, now he's not holding on. Magsayo, he got tied up there, but you saw him. He squatted down, and he threw some uppercuts into the belly of Hermosillo. And that's what I was talking about. That's what Freddie was just talking about. You got to use the opportunity wherever you are, inside or outside, to score.
And then also Freddie was telling him, keep your defense tight. I almost felt like Freddie felt that sometimes Magsayo can get a little bit lazy and drop his hands and his guard.
Well, he does it all the time. If you see him, he keeps, after he works a couple of punches, he goes down and he grabs his belt line with both hands. See, like right there. He's done it 100 times tonight.
It's a habit, I'm sure, that Freddie Roach and his assistant trainer, Marvin Simodio, are trying to break, but let us not forget, this is just their first fight together. They've been working together steadily for 3 months consecutively. consecutively. Magsayo came here to the United States as we are at the midway point of the sixth round in February before COVID. Once that got going, he went back to the Philippines, returned in July to spend a full 3 months with Freddie Roach.
Good body shots by Hermosillo, and then a nice little counter left uppercut by Magsayo. But, you know, he does have to get busier. He is starting to look a little bit fatigued right now, Magsayo, which means that his punches may not be as effective. And that's not good when you're fighting a guy that's swarming you like Hermosillo. He's, you know, kind of being unstoppable with his pressure right now. And you got to have power to get a guy's respect, not just to walk you down like that.
We'll see if Magsayo can find a way to gain more sustained offense as he's dealing with someone who is very much aggressive and has quite a bit of tenacity in Hermosillo.
Boy, good body shot right there. That kind of hurt Magsayo right there, that little left hand to the liver. As he grabs his shorts again.
He bent over a little bit. He still might be feeling the remnants of that liver shot, Joe.
Oh, I'm telling you, this is those hurt more than you might suspect. Again, it doesn't take much to hurt you to the body.
End of the sixth stanza. Big right hook that connected for Magsayo. And a left hook to end the sixth,
Okay, there's a long, kind of sloppy left hand. But you see how that right hand is down from Hermosillo, and then Magsayo can do that well. And here's that right hand, boom. I mean, he's really accurate with that. Magsayo's down and grabs his shorts there. Here he slips under the right
hand. Rounds, do you think that the right hand might be hurt for Magsayo?
You know, he did kind of show it to the corner. I don't know if that was just another quirky thing he does, like, you know, grabbing his belt line. But, yeah, I noticed that, too.
I'm very curious to see in the seventh round if Magsayo starts to throw the right hand or if it might be damaged.
Well, let me tell you something. Even if it's hurt, he'll throw it.
Very good question, but will he throw it with as much frequency is the question.
Whether it's, I think the question is, will he throw it with as much power? You know, he'll throw it when you have to just to, you know, to at least keep a guy off balance, knowing he has to protect himself, but will it have any power behind it?
That is why he is the best in the business, the legendary Joe Goosen, educating me every single time we get together here on FS1. Ray Flores, Joe Goosen, Jordan Plant into the seventh round of this featherweight main event. Mark Magsayo from the Philippines fighting here in the United States for the first time in 4 years. There's a straight left that found its destination for Hermosillo. Another one.
Well, Magsayo threw a right hand and missed it. Hermosillo slipped to his left a little bit and came back with the counter left hand, and that buzzed him.
This has been a very entertaining featherweight matchup.
It's a dangerous fight for both guys because both guys are really, you know, they're strong guys. These are not weak punchers. They may not be one-punch knockout punchers in this particular fight, but let me tell you, they're landing some damaging punches right now, both guys.
They're certainly going to feel the effects of this fight in the morning. As you take a look at the numbers, 106 landed for Hermosillo compared to just 72 for Magsayo. That seemed a little bit low.
Well, if it was, Jack Reeks was completely behind Magsayo, but that was mostly on the belt.
We heard it here at our broadcast position under a minute to go here in the seventh.
Well, it's like I said in my points to victory, you got to hit the body hard. And Hermosillo's capable of doing that with that strong left hand. And, of course, you heard his trainer telling him, you got to use, what did he say?
He wants him to use the left and also give some head movement and keep his guard up.
That's right. But the first thing he told him, he wants him to use that left hand.
Yes.
A lot.
Absolutely. He said, use the left. It's what he was imploring him to do.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. There's a straight left that was decked Magsayo.
It was a right hand by Magsayo that was countered with a quick left hand by Hermosillo. So they both landed. They're both doing good damage here to each other. Let me tell you, both scoring good points. This is a tough one.
A right hand that crashed into Hermosillo. His moments of brilliance in the seventh.
right hand. Hermosillo slips.
As the corner of Hermosillo
there it is. There's
though.
Yeah, there's that slip and comeback counter right there. That was the last.
Joe, both men have sanctioning bodies hoping to elevate his standing and remain perfect against Rigoberto Hermosillo. Hermosillo on the opposite side looking to end his two-fight losing streak. The left hook to the body by Magsayo. Joe, at this stage of the fight, what would you like to see out of both men first with Magsayo?
Well, I think Magsayo is just, you know, I think he's probably winning this fight. I don't think there's a doubt. I think he's winning the fight. You know, I just think what Freddie told him was correct, was, you know, you got to punch in combinations. You got to stay busier than the other guy and do damage when you hit him. You know, you try to hurt the guy when you hit him. On the other side with Hermosillo, well, at this stage of the game, I would want, if I were in the corner, I'd want you to win every second of the last few rounds you got, without a doubt. Make it clear that you're the winner of these rounds, because you're probably behind right now. So you got to put complete pressure on, keep your hands busy, and try to, you know, put Magsayo down with something, or at least hurt him with something, where it's obvious to the judges.
Joe, moments ago, Hermosillo just ate a lethal left hook on the chin by Magsayo, and he ate it well and just kept coming forward.
That's right, and then he landed, right as you were speaking, he landed a great liver shot with a little left uppercut to the belly, and, well, you know, Magsayo really reacted to it, but he's in such great shape, he's able to shake it off. You know, if you're in, you know, inferior shape, you're not going to be able to shake off those body shots that he's getting hit with. See right there. See, that's Magsayo being busy and close. That's what Freddie wanted. You know, he landed a couple punches. He turned. He moved out, angled up, and then got busy again. So that's stuff that wins you the rounds.
Magsayo started to really target the body in these past 45 seconds, Joe.
Yeah, look, Magsayo will hit anything that you give him. You give him the head or the body, he's gonna find it. He's got a variety of punches where I think Hermosillo really over-depends on that left hand right there. See, that's three in a row right there with his left hand. Finally, a hook. Four. So four left hands to one hook, two hooks. Now one that missed. Where Magsayo, look, he goes to the body, he's got left hooks, right hands, straight right hands, hooks to the head, and he blends them all together in combination. So, you know, he's a little harder to predict.
We told you when Mexico and the Philippines get together in boxing, it is no shortage of entertainment, and thus far that has been the case. Both men pushing each other in our main event. Outlanding Magsayo 48-28. When it comes to Magsayo, he has not landed more than four body shots in any round until the eighth, when he landed nine. So clearly, from a body punching standpoint, it favors the Mexican in Hermosillo.
Yeah, and look, I think that was that. Oh, good combo. See, and there we go. You got.
And that is not a knockdown.
Turn around, box.
No, he could have had he not bumped him. You see, Magsayo kind of bumped him a little bit. A
couple of right hands that spray Hermosillo by Magsayo.
Well, Magsayo's really, he must have gotten a big push from the corner from Freddie right now, because he came out blasting as if he needed to do this, and Freddie probably insisted on it. But man, he came out of the chute really fast, Magsayo, with some really sharp, sharp punches.
Freddie might have lit a fire under Magsayo. When it comes to going the distance, Maxio's 4-0 past eight rounds, so no stranger to fighting long stretches of fights. As Mark Magsayo undefeated after eight rounds. I mean, he's undefeated, period, but even more so, having the experience of going 10 and 12 rounds.
And right now, look, Magsayo is blending a little boxing with a little pressure. He's not getting hit, but he's landing all the damaging punches this round. Good left hook. But Hermosillo landed a nice little left hand at the same time. And here Hermosillo got in close and landed a few body shots. But it's been all Magsayo this round.
Just over the halfway point of the ninth.
Ooh, You can hear those
left through the body. Oh my!
Somebody grunted in there. I don't know if it was Jack Reese, if it was Hermosillo, but let me tell you, that was a beautiful left hand that he threw in there.
Magsayo, though, to be undeterred as he looks for his opening. Magsayo making his debut with Freddie Roach as his trainer also. This is his first fight under Manny Pacquiao Promotions, his new promoter. He was away from the ring for 16 months from November of 2017 to March of 2019 due to promotional issues, but that has all been rectified. Vicious left hook for Magsayo.
Boy, it's been all Magsayo this round. Let me tell you something. Not only has he been doing very well offensively, defensively, he's really used some good matrix, style movements to avoid punches from Hermosillo. So, I give him a lot of credit. Just like that. Underneath punches, pulled out nice. Made Hermosillo fall short with his punches, go over his head. He's doing really well in this round.
Uppercut by Magsayo, followed by a right as he puts together November of 2017 to March of 2019 due to promotional issues, but that has all been rectified. Vicious left hook for Magsayo.
Boy, it's been all Magsayo this round. Let me tell you something. Not only has he been doing very well offensively, defensively, he's really used some good matrix style movements to avoid punches from Hermosillo. So, I give him a lot of credit. Just like that. Underneath punches, pulled out nice. Made Hermosillo fall short with his punches, go over his head. He's doing really well in this round.
Uppercut by Magsayo, followed by a right. As he puts together more combinations, does the undefeated Filipino featherweight. But back comes Hermosillo. One more. Jack Reese.
Yeah, you're going to see they bang bodies here, if I'm not mistaken. Right. There is a good left hook. And then see, nice little rally again. But see, pulled away on this fight. And is comfortably ahead right now. So, I just think Freddie wanted him to, don't be an underachiever in this fight. Use all of your skills, use all the training, and let it all go right now. Why waste any of it?
Talk about motivation in between the 9th and the 10th from Hall of Fame trainer Freddie Roach. Just over the halfway point, a left hook by Magsayo, but answering back with the left of his own is Hermosillo. This has been a terrific fight, Joe, between two men who are giving their all inside that ring.
I'm going to tell you something, Magsayo, the longer he's with Freddie and that group, the more this is only his first fight with him. Let me just tell you something, he's going to be somebody to. I think Magsayo really has to get in there and bang it out with him like this. But I think Freddie saw that he had him real hurt last round. He had him hurt, and that Magsayo, is still got the availability and the power to knock out Hermosillo or do a lot of damage. I really don't think Freddie thinks he's behind.
Joe, you hear it thrown around in boxing. Can he kick it into another gear? I think Freddie's trying to get Magsayo to really step his foot on the gas to try to get out of there, because he saw moments of that in the ninth.
Well, I think Freddie's done that for the past 3-4 rounds. That's why, I think Magsayo pulled away on this fight. And is comfortably ahead right now. So, I just think Freddie wanted him to, don't be an underachiever in this fight. Use all of your skills, use all the training, and let it all go right now. Why waste any of it?
Talk about motivation in between the 9th and the 10th from Hall of Fame trainer Freddie Roach. Just over the halfway point, a left hook by Magsayo, but answering back with the left of his own is Hermosillo.
Step away.
This has been a terrific fight, Joe, between two men who are giving their all inside that ring.
I'm going to tell you something, Magsayo, the longer he's with Freddie and that group of guys in that gym, the more this is only his first fight with them. Let me just tell you something, he's going to be somebody to be reckoned with, because he has got a lot of skills defensively as well as offensively. Quick hands, powerful, can slip, can turn, can pivot. I like him.
Magsayo, a big right that momentarily wobbled Hermosillo. Magsayo has stated in the near future he wants the champions at 126. For Hermosillo, I would love to see him again, without a doubt.
Oh, yeah.
Vicious body punching between these two.
Well, that was a nice little flurry by Hermosillo, but I think a little too late, you know. We got 10 seconds here.
Was a very entertaining Seal Go the Distance show. This one was entertainment without a doubt.
Oh, look, I mean, there was a lot of back and forth, and Hermosillo might have been a little busier, but he certainly wasn't as accurate and damaging as Magsayo was. So, you know, you had a lot of stuff going on in this fight, but this was top shelf fighting right here by both guys.
When it comes to the punch, then.
Yeah, listen, I mean, you kind of summed it up in that last round. They both went for broke in that last round here. But look, there was, you know, over 1,200 punches thrown here, it looks like.
Gentlemen, having completed the full 10 rounds, we go to the scorecards. Judge at ringside, Rudy Barragan, scores it 100-90 in favor of Magsayo. Judge Dr. Lou Moret scores it 96-94 for Hermosillo. And Judge Zachary Young scores it 96-94 for your winner by split decision. And still undefeated, Mark Magnifico Magsayo.